I'm Tony Velasquez, and welcome to Future Perfect Tech Shorts. First up, our science and tech wrap. Startup Weekend in Manila recently launched their third edition, which pooled together developers, designers, marketers, and even designers for several breakthrough applications. Well, short of trying to change the world, the startup enthusiasts were stepping outside their comfort zones, getting some one-on-one time with the movers and shakers of the tech industry, and turning their ideas into reality.
A great application not only involves a good team of developers, you also need eye-catching graphics and a solid business model. We have an event that brings together all three, the hipsters, the hustlers, and the geeks. Welcome to Startup Weekend Manila.
The main idea behind this is to drive entrepreneurship by providing a playground for young people to actually try out how would it feel to set up a startup and so on, and play pitch, come up with a business idea, make it, build a team. We are trying to build the spirit that it is okay to take a risk.
The event wants to emphasize you don't have to quit your daytime job to execute your big idea. It's another way of earning your keep outside of the corporate ladder. But there's a catch. You need to be able to launch a startup in 54 hours.
The first day, the ones who are going to pitch an idea, their greatest problem is, what will I say in 1 minute? When they get to the second day, their biggest problem will be, okay, what is that? I will continue my idea, but what next? What will I do? The third day, the last day, around 3 o'clock, their worst problem will be fear. Because it's now, I'm going to speak to judges, I'm going to pitch 4 minutes now, what will they say about me?
Participants also have to be able to make a business case out of their ideas. Among Filipino developers, Startup Weekend has seen a mix of projects, from socially engaged type of applications to a few addressing specific needs.
30% more or less on, again, the trying to be the next Facebook type, the popular consumer apps type. Another 30% focusing on really helping, you know, less able people.
But organizers say the most important feature of an event like this is the professional feedback, the reality check coming from insiders themselves.
The ones who pitch it, they think that they have the best solution in the world. They get to see what really is involved in building a business. And they realize, oh no, it takes more than just my gung-ho, I want to change the world passion, right? You need to also have people who can think through the business model.
If you didn't get to join this edition of Startup Weekend, don't worry, there's another one in the offing.
Everybody who wants to try out something new, the next one's in Cebu, Davao, in November. We will announce the venues. Just check out startupweekend.org.
You're trying to conserve on music as well. Well, when conserving water or fuel, you only need to look at the meter to monitor your usage in real time. But when it comes to electricity, it's not that simple. Now, there's a device that can keep track of and store power consumption data for up to 24 months. Now, think of it as a CCTV, yes, that device that you can use to catch the thieves as they're rummaging through your store. The CCTV for your electricity. Joining us in the studio are Jose and Timothy Domingo. Magkapatid yan, ha? Akala nyo lang, ha? They'll tell us more about this innovative power consumption monitoring system. Joe and Timothy. Magkapatid nga naman talaga, di ba? Okay.
Pwede na.
Pwede na. Okay. Yeah. Ilang taon lang agwat. Tell us more about JC Domingo Enterprises Corp and what you're doing with this power meter.
Well, our company is 54 years old. And we're better known in the food processing industries and packaging. Mm-hmm. So among the concerns of these factories now is to cut down costs where possible. And the last thing they try to do that is on energy.
Yes,
because they usually use it on raw materials. But now they started asking us about last year to source some systems or gadgets to reduce the their consumption. Mm. But there are plenty of these gadgets around, but they're not really working fine. Mm. So when Timmy studied this and he went to England, to get some ideas there, and he found this.
Yeah, okay. And what is this exactly, Tim?
Well, this is the real-time monitor that we call. Mm-hmm. So you get, if you turn on something or turn it off, you're going to see the data in kilowatts, and also in cost, mm-hmm. so in peso or in also in carbon. Then you get the voltage. You get the voltage information, also the power factor.
Okay.
How so if is you turn on, turn off something, you can see it right away.
Okay. Obviously, you're monitoring consumption, but how do you do that? I mean, where are you connected to?
You connect it to the circuit breaker or to the appliance itself.
To the circuit breaker. Yeah. And what do you use to connect to the circuit breaker?
We have a current transformer. So this one is a live feed from our office here in Quezon City. But you can also, for as long as there's an internet, you can get it.
Is there a sample of the device or what it looks like, the current transformer that you connect to the
Well, current transformer is pretty common. It's off the shelf.
Okay.
So you just connect it to the meter.
Mm-hmm. And then you connect it
to a computer.
Okay.
Then the computer...
How is it connected to the computer?
By LAN.
Okay. So it's an Ethernet LAN connection?
Yeah. And then it goes. The data is thrown to the cloud,
okay.
then broadcasted to the internet.
Okay. And you can pick it up from anywhere in the world.
Yeah.
You should log on to a website, I suppose.
Yes, yeah.
And you have a login account.
Login account. Mm. That's just like, you know, the email account.
This was a British system that was developed.
Correct. Yeah.
Okay. So what is it called? Enter?
AnyGene.
AnyGene. Okay. Yeah. AnyGene. So how long has this been in use in the UK?
So the company was for 3 years now.
Okay.
For three years. And starting from 3 years ago, they have developed the software.
Mm-hmm.
Before you get every 30-minute update, but now we get minute-by-minute update.
Mm-hmm.
And they added additional information like kVARs, reactive power, apparent power, carbon. Before, it's just kilowatts.
Now, all of these, as you said, Joe, are actually meant for... manufacturing facilities or enterprises,
correct.
Right? That
correct.
Have a lot of that have a huge demand for energy.
Right, because you have to identify the power hogs, and you have three sources.
Mm-hmm.
One is the heating and air conditioning.
Yeah.
The other one is light, and then the other is motors. And the motors are really dynamic. You can adjust. There are no two factors that have the same profile or map.
Yeah.
So that's. This engine now is very important for those who would like to really have a program to address their concern.
Yeah.
Because you got to have a map first.
A map.
You cannot just buy gadgets to reduce the...
Sure.
Yeah. Mm.
So does the system tell you where the power hogs are?
Yeah. Right.
Okay. So for example, you're connected now. You're actually monitoring your office now.
Yeah.
Okay.
So no, I also have information because as you mentioned earlier, it can store data for 24 months.
Yeah.
So you get to see this data as well. So here's a pie chart, so you know where to isolate. Mm-hmm. So this is an installation that we did in Guam.
The orange
one is for the chillers. Then the blue one is for the kitchen and lighting. And then this one is the elevator.
Is that a restaurant that you installed?
It's a hotel in Guam.
Yeah.
So. Now they have they can make more intelligent decision because they want to use. They were about to install LEDs. You know.
So the orange part again is for the chillers.
Yeah.
Right.
So you can isolate. So it is more rational for them to invest energy saving device on the chillers instead of other things.
And this is their consumption pattern for how long already?
You can get it for a day.
Ah, just for the daily?
For the day, you can get for 7 days, whatever you want, or
I see.
Particular part of the day.
And it will show you over a period of 24 months how your consumption varies.
Yeah. So if you go to the dashboard right here, you can see the kilowatt hour for today. I mean it's a running total
for today.
Then you get the carbon and also the cost.
Okay.
So you see that it's in
so
it's
this
in
is
US
like your
dollars.
Equivalent carbon emissions.
Yes,
CO2.
Yes, that is.
Okay.
And then you get three colors here because they have three meters installed.
Yeah.
So this one is the chiller, the orange one, then the green is the elevator, and then the blue is the kitchen and lighting.
Mm-hmm. Right. So how does it you know, I mean, over a period of time, it shows you where your power is going to, which one actually siphons a lot of energy off.
Right.
And as you say, you have to decide what device you can install.
That's right.
To help you cut down. What devices are those?
So we have torque controls.
Torque
for the motors. Motors.
Yeah.
Then we have VFDs, variable frequency drives, for speed controls.
Okay.
And then we have for the ACs and for the refrigeration.
Mm-hmm.
So for the case of this hotel, we know it's pretty obvious. The orange ones are on the ones on top.
Yeah. So the chillers are the ones.
The chillers, so
using
yeah.
a lot.
So but here they have. If you see that, here they did not install anything yet, but they saved a lot compared to the previous days.
Mm.
So it's more on putting up policies, when to turn it on and off. You know okay. when it's practical.
Because I'm kind of thinking, what is the initial investment for something like this? If you're going to put up a system, an energy
okay.
system.
Okay, a system like this would cost about 310,000 pesos.
Pesos.
So
depending on the size of the
well,
the business.
You're going to add additional for additional meters. So
okay.
it depends on the company.
So 300,000 is for a starter,
yeah.
starter kit.
Yeah.
Yeah. And what do you get with a starter kit?
You get a hub and then you get a meter,
a yeah. hub and a meter.
Yes.
Yeah. And then you get the because since it's cloud computing equipment,
yeah.
you get a subscription for 24 months included in the package.
Okay, but. Of course, you're saying you have to monitor different areas of the facility, right? In this case, the hotel in Guam, you're monitoring the chillers, the kitchen,
the elevator,
and the elevator
so
motors.
They decided to have 3 meters.
So three different meters,
yes.
right?
Mm-hmm.
And the hub actually gets all the information from all those different
The hub
meters.
Can handle 10 meters.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So to add a meter to every part of the facility would cost how much?
It's about 75,000 pesos.
Another 75,000
yeah.
for me. Now, if you're talking about enterprises or production facilities,
yeah.
right? I mean, the cost obviously
yeah.
is not something a typical homeowner would invest
right.
in, right? So, not a lot of homeowners are actually your target, no?
Well, we have similar, but not as detailed information because you don't need detailed information for residential use.
Yeah.
So we have this meter right here
okay.
for residential use.
This is for home use.
Yeah.
Right.
That one
okay.
right there.
So it, you connect it to the circuit breaker. The
circuit
same?
Breaker as well. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then also it goes with a swivel disc.
Okay.
Then
let me just put that there.
Then you can right. you can get also
the consumption pattern.
Yeah, the consumption pattern.
24 months as
yeah.
well.
The software is for free. When you buy the meter, you get the software.
The software
for
is
free.
For free.
So this one gets storage for 240 days. So if you want to see your pattern for the day or pattern for the month, or you can also set the target for how many kilowatt hours you want to use in a day. If you're going above it, then it's going to alarm.
Really? It will
yeah,
give
yeah.
you an audible alarm that
yeah.
you're over your set consumption pattern.
Yeah.
Okay. How much would the home kit cost? Because 300,000 for the enterprise, for the home?
This is about 6,000 pesos.
6,000? So, okay,
yeah.
not bad.
Yeah.
I mean, if it's going to help you monitor your consumption.
Just
yeah.
one Friday evening,
don't go out for dinner on Friday.
Friday evening? Well, depende. Now, tell me, what is the, well, parang your official relationship, say, with the power company, di ba? Parang, okay, you're helping them cut down on power.
Well,
the power companies are also trying to encourage consumers
yes, of course,
to
because
cut down on power.
The more efficient we are, then the less investment they will have to put up for additional power plants or something like that.
Okay.
So in a way, we're helping them, we're helping the community and also the environment.
Mm.
Yeah.
Precisely. So for people who actually invest in these things, they can quantify how much they can save, no?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh. See, you applied it to your office, obviously.
Yes,
yeah.
we did.
How much have you saved?
Today, we have accumulated about 32% off
okay.
our base in April.
Off from your April consumption?
Yes.
32%.
Yeah.
Our energy bill then, in April was 50,000. And
went down to
35.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually lower, it's
32,000.
Has anyone invested in a home kit so far?
For the home kit, it's quite new, so
okay.
we're just promoting it.
Yeah.
But It'll be available within this week.
I see. Yeah. Okay, so people might be interested. Yeah. So they check out. Where do they go to?
They can go to our website.
Which is?
It's www.firstgreenergy.com. First is number one, S and then T.
One S T.
G R E E N E R G Y dot com.
Okay.
First Green Energy.
First Green Energy.
Yeah.
Okay. So ano po age difference ninyo magkapatid?
Times two.
Fantastic. Joe and Tim, thanks very much for coming.
Thank you too for your time.
Explaining how the energy system works. Obviously, Meralco wants to increase power rates all the more.
Yeah.
They haven't stopped. So people might take note of how this thing can help them save on power costs. Thanks very much for coming.
Thank you very much.
Well, coming up next, we take the wraps off Samsung's Galaxy Note 10.1, multi-screen, built-in Adobe Photoshop, seamless sharing. More when we return. You're watching Future Perfect Tech Shorts. Welcome back to Future Perfect Tech Shorts. Well, it's bigger, it's faster, it's extra powerful and more dazzling, and I'm not just talking about a hamburger. The Samsung Galaxy Note 10.1 promises to redefine the tablet experience with a multi-screen button, an all-new S Pen, and even a built-in Adobe Photoshop Touch. Now, whether you're watching downloaded videos or catching the latest viral sensation on YouTube, you'll be able to see everything in bright, crystal clear, high definition. It also has a larger battery, which means less frequent charging. And here to tell us more about the features of the Samsung Galaxy Note 10.1, Stephanie Chua, coming back to Future Perfect. Stephanie is the product manager for Samsung tablets. Thanks very much, Stephanie, for coming back.
Good evening.
Yes. Okay. Now I'm holding the same device that you have, except mine is what? Titanium.
It's titanium silver, and I have here the ceramic white.
The ceramic white. Now, we all know about the Samsung tabs. Galaxy Tab comes in different sizes.
Yes.
And now this 10.1 comes in a Note version.
Yes.
Okay. What makes the 10.1 Galaxy Tab different from a Galaxy Note 10.1?
Well, as you can see here, I'm holding an S Pen.
Okay.
It's one of the main differences of the Galaxy Note 10.1 with the other tablets in the market.
All right.
So it's no longer just for media consumption, like watching your videos or browsing the internet or reading e-books. Now, because of the S Pen, you can actually create your content. You can take down notes.
Okay.
You can edit your pictures with Adobe Photoshop.
Okay.
And you can do so much more than just watching or just browsing the internet now.
Okay, because we were introduced to the S Pen also when the Galaxy Note 2 came out. That's the phone. And the Galaxy Note 2 S Pen actually activates several applications, right?
Yes.
Okay, so are they the same applications with the phone in the Note 2?
Well, most of them are the same. And the most... important application to take notice, the S Note.
It's called the Note. So that's why the Galaxy Note is useful for taking notes.
Yes, because it works perfectly with your S Pen.
Yeah.
And with the S Note, you have different templates for different uses, like if you're in a meeting, or if you just want to draw, or if you want to make a recipe or anything, you have an S Note template to work with.
Okay.
And for example, I'm going to a meeting and I want to take notes. So I can open my S Note and just write down take down everything.
But first, you have to explain, Stephanie, because you were demonstrating it before you went on the air. Before you actually even try to write anything using handwritten letters, you have to tap on...
So you can use the S Pen to write down anything.
Okay.
And if you want to make your notes more formal and more readable,
you
actually
have
this one. It's the productivity tools.
Productivity tools.
Yes, you can see that there are three different productivity tools, and one of them is what you're talking about, is the handwriting recognition. So what you can do is just write down any word, and the S Note will automatically convert it into a text format.
Okay.
So for example, I will write down.
I will give you a sentence so that I know. This is something Stephanie hasn't practiced yet.
Okay, so.
Yeah. I love guesting on Future Perfect.
So I'll write down I, as you can see. Okay. I'm not sure.
As you can see.
No, what?
It disappeared. Okay.
So here, I'll write down I.
Okay.
Sorry, did you see that?
Yeah. Okay. Now let's do it this way.
Sorry. Okay.
Let's do it this way. Turn the other way. Face this way, Stephanie. Face
okay,
this way.
There.
Face this way.
Sorry,
all
there.
All right, so the camera will be at your back. Now.
Okay, there.
Okay, just go straight,
so,
right. I love guessing off
your turn. I love.
Okay. Do you have to stop?
No, not really, but.
Okay, go ahead and write it as you would.
Guessing.
Okay.
In.
Mm-hmm.
ANC.
Okay. Well, you didn't say Future Perfect, right?
I'm sorry.
Okay,
sorry, wrong show.
Okay.
Okay, I'll write Future Perfect.
All right, on Future,
Future
Perfect.
Future. Okay. Perfect. Sorry.
So where is it?
It's here, sorry. I had to separate it in two texts, but I love.
Okay. Because if you're actually writing notes, you were in a meeting, and you're jotting down notes. Yeah.
Guesting there. Oh, so I think my handwriting is not that. Oops.
Does it have to be taught to recognize your handwriting?
No, because actually it can recognize any handwriting, whether it's print or cursive. You can write down anything.
Because remember, with other devices before, the original handwriting recognition, you had to teach the
device. Yes, there's a stroke that you have
to
practice.
Yeah.
But this one, you can just write down the normal way that you do in a conventional notebook.
And it will recognize it.
Yes.
Okay. So the accuracy rate, would you say, not that perfect? I mean,
not that perfect, but I think it's 90% there.
Okay, fantastic. So what else can you do with a note that you don't... that you don't get to do with the 10.1.
And another thing that you can do is, for example, you wanna draw tables or diagrams.
Okay, clear out the text first.
Sorry. Yeah. We have here what we call the shape match.
Okay.
So you can just draw any shape, and the S note will automatically.
Okay, the camera didn't get that.
Sorry.
Stephanie. So let's just clear the screen.
I will.
Oh, you can erase it with
I
the
can
S
erase,
note. Can't you just delete button?
Okay, I can just close.
Close that. Okay. Now let's show the shape.
Okay, and then I can just open a new one.
Open a new one. Okay. So say for example, I want to draw a map. So I just draw buildings.
Yes.
And stuff.
So
okay.
For example, I'll open the productivity tools here.
Okay.
So I'll choose shape match, and I want to draw buildings.
A building. Okay.
So I can just draw rectangles there.
And it will convert itself into a perfect rectangle.
Yes. And maybe you want to draw a pie chart for a meeting.
Yeah.
So there you can just do it there. And you can even...
That's pretty cool.
You can even change colors. So you can...
Shade that and
represent it with something else. Just like...
There's no autofill function so that you can just shade that entire portion?
For this particular application, we have what you call the Adobe Photoshop. And if you want to do autofill or what other tricks, you can do it in Adobe Photoshop.
Now, draw a cat.
Okay. I'm not that.
you can't draw a cat. Okay. So, what else can we do? With a note, 10.1.
Another productivity tool that is really cool is what we call the formula match.
Formula.
So if mothers and fathers out there are trying to, you know, teach their kids, what we can do is just write down any equation, maybe,
write down an equation.
What equation can you write?
Does it have to be a scientific formula?
X squared plus y squared is equal to 38.
Okay. Yeah, whatever.
Okay.
So.
Oops, sorry.
Yeah.
I didn't. Sorry. X squared plus y squared is equal to 38.
Uh-huh.
There. What I can do is search.
Search.
Okay,
are you doing, you have to be connected to
the
network?
I have to be connected to the internet, so I'll just connect here shortly.
Yeah.
There. So I will search.
Yeah.
And automatically the tablet will give you the answer.
It will.